एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय वीडियो। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डू द मैच प्रीव्यू ऑफ इंडिया वर्सेस श्रीलंका सेकंड T20। सो इन द फर्स्ट गेम यू सॉ दैट हाउ शॉ गॉन फॉर अ गोल्डन डक एंड शिखर धवन played a good 46 knock. Sanju Samson just 27. He was batting exceptionally well, but trapped by Hasaranga, and Surya Kumar Yadav brilliant, scored half century is in a good form. And number 5, Hardik Pandya, just gone for 10, he is in a bad form. But 6, Ishan Kishan in a normal form, but he scored 20 runs from 14 balls, not out, 1-4-1-6, and he did the finishing job for India as well. Krunal Pandya just 3 runs but not out. This was India's batting in first. T20. So let's talk about Sri Lanka's batting in first T20. So opener Avishka Fornado gone for 26, and his partner Vinod Banuka gone for 10. Krunal Pandya got his wicket, and number 3 Dhananjay Disilva gone for 9, and Chahal bowled him with a beauty. It was a leg spin, he didn't tread it. He thought the ball is coming on the leg stump. For example, this is Dhananjay DeSilva. These are 3 wickets. He's standing here. He thought the ball is coming here, so he was trying to play on the on side here, but the ball went on the off stump. And number 4, Charit Hasalaka played very nicely, good 44. And number 5, Bandara gone for 9, he was a bowler, only batting at 5, because bowler didn't got a chance to bowl. So, Dasun Chanaka sent him at 5. Because he didn't got a chance to bowl. Number 6, Dasun Chanaka, gone for 16. Number 7, Vanindu Hasaranga, duck. Number 8, Chamika Karunaratne, gone for 3. Number 9, Izuru Dana, gone for 1. And Dushmanta Chamira, Meera, bowled by Bhuvneshwar and gone for 0, and Alika Dhananjaya 1 not out. So this was Sri Lanka's batting. So now let's come to a topic, which was the second T20 match preview. So let's talk about the schedule. So for next 2 matches, means second T20 and third T20. So the second T20 will be played at 27 July and third T20 will be played at 29th July. Let's talk about the timings for both of these T20s. So the timings are 8 p.m. And now let's talk about the weather report. It will be little rainy. It can rain 80%, but I don't know about Sri Lanka, because the weather changes in Sri Lanka at any time. Now let's talk about the live telecasting. So you can watch this match on Sony 6 in English, Sony 101 in English, Sony 103 in Hindi, and Sony 104 in Tamil or Telugu. This was the live telecasting. So let's talk about the playing 11 for the both teams, which was our main topic. Our main topic was only to cover the playing 11s. So let's talk about Sri Lanka's playing 11. Opener, Avishka Fernando. He's in a golden form. He scored 2 half centuries in ODI. Batted nicely in first ODI also, but he was trapped by Yuzi Chahal on 33. And he played 26. He got 26 runs in the first T20. Avishka Fernando, my first opener. Second opener would be Vinod Banoka, because he's an opener and Sri Lanka. I thought that he just scored 10 runs, so I could keep another wicket keeper. But Sri Lanka has only one keeper for the series, who is Vinod Banoka. He's the wicket keeper for the series. And let's talk about number 3. Number 3, there would be one change. Banoka Rajapaksa could replace Bandana. Bandana is a bowler and he batted at number 5, but Banoka Rajapaksa will replace him and he would come at number 3. And he scored 177 also in T20, so he's a good player, he's a good batsman. So Banoka Rajapaksa at number 3. And he batted really well in third ODI, scored 65 runs. Okay, so no doubt they would go with Banoka Rajapaksa. And number 4, Charit Asalaka. Dhananjay De Silva will play at 5, but I want Asalaka to come before Dhananjay De Silva, because he is also in a very good form. He's in a good form, scoring runs. He batted very nicely in the ODI series, scored a 50 also, 65 runs or 68 runs in the second T20. First T20, 2nd ODI. And in first ODI he scored 38, and in the third ODI he scored 24, and in the first T20 he was exceptional, gone for 44, but he was playing very nicely and with a good strike rate. So he would bat at number 4. Number 5, Dhananjay De Silva. He is a good player, they would not miss him. Dhananjay, he just performed in second ODI, scored 32. That is also not too good, but also it's not too bad as well. And first ODI 14, and 2 in third ODI, 9 in first T20. He's in an average form. And he scored 91 against England in 2021 only in second ODI. He can get some confidence from that match, and he can bat nicely in the second T20. Number 6, no doubt the captain, Dasun Shanaka, not in a good form. Scored 39 in first ODI and 16 in second ODI and gone for duck in the third ODI. He scored 16 in the first T20, not in a good form, average form, because he had a great tour of England. He is in average form. Number 7, Chamika Karunaratne. He is a good all-rounder. You would be shocked that why I didn't took the name of Vanindu Hasaranga. No Sri Lankan fans, I'll take his name. He's an exceptional spinner. I like his spin bowling. But I thought that Karunaratne can bat more nicely than Vanindu Hasaranga. Then I then only then from that only I said that Karuna Ratne will bat at 7, but I have more chances to Hasaranga for her to bat at 7, but Chamika Karuna Ratne can bat more nicely than Vanindu Hasaranga. Number 8, Vanindu Hasaranga, no doubt. He's an exceptional spinner. Got Sanju Samson in his first ball, not in the debut first ball. He played many T20s. He's in third or fourth in T20 rankings, but he got Sanju Samson wicket in his first delivery. Okay, so Vanindu Hasaranga, no doubt at 8. Isuru Dana at 9. Because he's a great batsman as well. He had scored 84 not out in T20s. So that shows that he can also he is also an all rounder. Number 10. Before Chamira, I want Alika Dhananjaya, because some people say that he is a all-rounder only. So Alika Dhananjaya will play at 10. He can also bat, and Dushmanta Chamira will play at number 11. This was my playing 11 for Sri Lanka. Now let's come on to India's playing 11 without wasting any single second. So, opener, Shikhar Dhawan, no doubt the captain, in a good form, great. He had a great IPL, great first ODI against Sri Lanka, second ODI, he was trapped by Hasaranga, and third ODI, he was trapped by Alika Dhananjaya. So, for 13. So, but then also, he's in a very good form, because he's shown that in first T20, he scored 46 runs from 36 balls. He had a great partnership with Sanju Samson, and he had a great partnership with Surya Kumar Yadav. So he'll bat at number 1 and number 2. There would be a one change. Prithvi Shaw could be rested because he'd gone for a golden duck in first T20. So they would come with Devdutt Padikkal, because Rahul Dravid said that he'll give the chance to every Indian player of the squad. The squad of 20 member squad. Then he gave the chance for 18 players to play, but he didn't give the chance to Devdutt Padikkal and Rituraj Gaikwad. If he would give the chance to Prithvi Shaw again, so only one could play in third T20, Devdutt Padikkal or Rituraj Gaikwad. So he could not give chance to everyone. So I want Devdutt Padikkal to open with Shikhar Dhawan. Number 3, I cannot keep Ishan Kishan because I need any right hander now. Both my openers are left. So I'll go with Sanju Spectacular Samson. Again, interesting batsman, and he's phenomenal. When he's in a power hitting mode, when he bats like a power hitter, he bats like some alien. Such a great batsman when he's in his mood. At number 4, Surya Kumar Yadav. Number 4, Surya Kumar Yadav scored a half century in last T20, first T20 match. And he performed really well on his T20 debut against England on Narendra Modi Stadium, which is which is called as Motera Stadium as well. He scored 57 there, and in his second T20 he scored 32. So Surya Kumar Yadav will definitely play at number 4, and number 5 they'll go with their wicket keeper Ishan Kishan. He's also very good batsman. He finished Indian innings in last T20, means the first T20 that was played on R. Premadasa Stadium, and he finished the innings, and so that's why I kept Ishan Kishan for number 5. Number 6, not in a good form, Hardik Pandya, but team cannot miss him. He's a perfect all-rounder. Number 7, Krunal Pandya. He is in a good form, so he will bat at number 7. Number 8, Deepak Chahar. And number 9, Bhuvneshwar Kumar. Both of them are in a good form. Deepak Chahar is in a good form with the bat as well. So he scored 69 not out in second ODI and won the game. And number 10. I had number 10. They would definitely go with a young talented leg spinner, Rahul Chahar. He's a good spinner. And number 11, Varun Chakravarti. Because I want that Rahul Chahar should play in place of Yuzi Chahal. I know that everyone knows that Yuzi Chahal is number 2 spinner in T20. Number 1 is Rashid Khan. Number 2 is Yuzvendra Chahal. He's a very good leg spinner. But I want, because Yuzi Chahal's place is fixed for T20 World Cup. So that's why I want to test Chahar also. So that's why I said Rahul Chahar to bat at number 10. So this was the playing 11 for the both of the teams. And let's talk about for a second and third T20, we missed that topic. So the venue will be R. Premadasa Stadium, Colombo. Okay? So bye. Please click on the like button and also click on the red color subscribe button and press the bell, that bell, to get notifications from my channel, so that when I'll upload one video, you can get notifications of it. You know that my videos are so important. I'm doing match previews so these videos are important. I always tell you playing 11 venues, new and venue schedule, timings, I tell you everything. So please, that's why I'm saying that subscribe, because my videos are important. So this was the match preview for India versus Sri Lanka, second T20. So comment that which team will win the second T20, and I'll definitely post on community as well that which team will win the second T20. It would be an exciting match. So bye.